For each and every year up until this point, we have been able to see Sony and Microsoft duke it out on the E3 stage, but I think it's finally time to say farewell to Sony at E3. That's right, Sony has come out and said that for the second year in a row now, they will not be attending the E3 conference for 2020. They came out and said that they do not feel the vision of E3 2020 is the right venue for what we are focused on this year, and our focus is on making sure fans feel part of the PlayStation family. Yeah, I guess E3 is just gonna have to do without one of its biggest selling points. And I read an article on IGN, it's actually a pretty good article for IGN, on why Sony leaving E3 doesn't hurt Sony. And this article really pretty well sums up like why Sony is not going to be hurt by this. If anything, it's not going to affect them at all, or even maybe benefit them this year for their PlayStation 5 release, right? It feels weird that Sony, being such a big company, and this being a year of next-gen consoles, that they're just going to entirely skip the biggest entertainment video game expo of the year, right? The one with the most media coverage, the most publicity, and where they can really showcase what they have to offer against Xbox, Nintendo, and all the other players, and also show some of their games. But after reading this article, I gotta say, yeah, I agree with it, and I don't think Sony is really making a bad move here. If anything, they're probably making a very smart move, and I would be darned if I didn't see some other companies such as Microsoft just completely ditching this conference in the future years of it to come. So we're all used to seeing Sony and Xbox both have their own little showtime during E3, and they get to show off what each other are doing. And in this past console generation, they have had some great little tidbits against each other, you know, poking fun at what the console can do, and it's just really been kind of some friendly rivalry that we've been able to cherish ourselves in and get some enjoyment out of. But Sony is now skipping this, and instead of doing E3 like they have done in past years, they're going to this year focus on hundreds of global events that they will hold in smaller venues. And I think the reason for this is because they will be able to get closer to their fan base, right? If you have 100 different shows across the world, it is so much easier for real PlayStation fans to be able to attend those events, oftentimes probably a lot much cheaper than E3, and they can have a more intimate connection with their fan base rather than just going to a big conference like E3, where it's all of these big names, everyone's vying for attention, and you're not going to be able to attract your most loyal audience, or those that do come are going to be few and far between from the people that would come to your conferences if you would hold it somewhere closer to where they lived. And another big reason why I think this is smart for Sony, or at least why Sony sees that it's a good move, is that it's just going to save them a crap ton of money. I mean, just looking at these numbers, it looks like to rent out space on E3's showroom floor, it costs hundreds of thousands of dollars for the week. On top of that, you have whatever showcase that you want to put on, the production costs of that, and the marketing cost behind all that at such a big event, and overall the lack of publicity potential that they could get from doing E3 against just doing their own thing, because they are vying against all of these other big names, and the media is just going to be constantly thrown around between Xbox, Nintendo, PlayStation, PC, whatever else is being shown at the show on that day. And because Sony is skipping E3 this year again, and they won't have to compete or try to get the eyes and the attention of so many publicity channels and media channels of what they've got to offer against everyone else. You know, E3 is a week in which is all this news comes out, and it's so hard to just kind of focus on one thing when it's just so muddled with everything else that's coming out. But with this move, what Sony's going to be able to do is really curate when and where they want the information for whatever they've got going on, PS5, and they're going to be able to really just manage when that information comes out. And because of this, they can release information that will come out when no other information about other competitors is coming out, which will just make the media jump on it and make it so much more noticeable in people's eyes. Because when E3 happens, all this, there's a giant news dump. And before and after E3, any news that comes out, it's big news, right? Because all this news came out at E3, there's kind of like this desert of information that's coming out about things. If Sony can pick a time where there's not a lot of information coming out about what other competitors are doing, and instead they can announce something big, or even just, you know, every couple of months announcing something little until it all culminates in something big about the next PlayStation 5, then it's a win for Sony, because they're going to be able to capitalize on the lack of news and really just capture people's attention and bring more awareness to what they're doing. And with this, I think people might think it's bad news because Sony and the news that they come out with is not going to be covered as much, and people aren't going to find out about it, and that the PlayStation 5 is really going to fly under the radar because Xbox is going to take over E3 and everyone's going to know about it and everyone's going to be focusing on that while everyone forgets about the PlayStation. And that is, in my opinion, simply not true. The PlayStation is coming off of one of the greatest console generations it's ever had, the PlayStation 4, against the Xbox One, which just did not nearly as well as the PlayStation 4. And because of that, I don't really think they need E3 as a platform to discuss what they've got going on. I mean, you can see this already where they've already published to other articles and media companies about what the PlayStation 5, little things about what the PlayStation 5 will offer. And they've done this and people have found out about it, and it's been news and it's been trickling out. And I think that's maybe a smarter move, to just trickle out information than just bam, here it is. But without a doubt, this is very sad, because I have always enjoyed watching E3, partly due to the fact that you had these two major companies, Microsoft and Sony, going head to head with some friendly rivalry, and it was just so fun to see and discuss after the show who won E3, right? Who came out with the better exclusives, or who had the better show? Overall, who had more going on and who was more interesting? And this is going to be pretty much missed this year, a lot like it was missed last year, but I think this year a little bit more so, because Sony is going to be trickling out this information, so it's just gonna kind of feel barren again. You know, after watching E3 last year, and this article mentions it too, they said that E3 felt kind of barren. It seemed like there was a big hole there that was missing, and I couldn't agree more. E3 definitely is, it takes a lot to keep the energy up and to make it exciting, and a lot of times during the show, it can be kind of very boring or dragged on, or the stuff that you don't really necessarily care about. And that rivalry, that little friendly competition between Microsoft and Sony, was really, I think, a big selling point in E3. So it really is sad to see that the PlayStation is not going to be attending this year. But overall, I think Sony is just making the right move for its business. And if they're able to come out with news and have people focus on them, at the times that make the most sense and bring out news when it will become the most relevant, right? And come out with the news about the PlayStation 5 when there's just nothing out about anything else. People will gravitate towards that, and just the whole hype around the PlayStation is just going to be that much more, because if the Xbox just comes out and reveals everything, then it's just a one and done deal, and the PlayStation is going to create more of this hype around it. So yeah, that's about it. If you want to let me know in the comments down below how you feel about Sony leaving E3, then go ahead and do so. But yeah, just remember, if you like this, leave a like and subscribe if you haven't, and that's it.